drop roll and help open yourself exposed.
So Eric, I remember seeing
Hello, it's Sade again, and I can't stop thinking about Project L, so let's make a video about it. Let's talk about Yasuo, specifically his moveset. While I did play several matches at Evo, I maybe only had like 2 minutes to fool around with the buttons, so apologies if this isn't comprehensive, but this is everything that I personally know, and to those interested in learning how Yasuo translated it into a fighting game, hopefully this video will help. I'll also try to explain some of the fighting game terms and put it into league terms just in case there are people who are newer to the fighting game genre. Lastly, keep in mind this info is probably going to change at some point. I mean, this is just an insanely early build and we don't even have an official name for the game yet, so yeah. But anyways, Project L Yasuo is essentially a League of Legends Yasuo's player's power fantasy. Like his League counterpart, he is a more technical character that offers a ton of skill expression. He has the ability to hyper carry a match and offers a variety of tools to style on everyone. Which I think is perfect because, I mean, every Yasuo player wants to be the main character of the story. At the same time, and I just think this is because of how the game was designed, but it also doesn't take much to feel cool playing him. So, difficult character to play at a high level, but still easy enough that you can eat glue and get away with it. Playing him legitimately just felt like League Yasuo, but Fang, and with a Yumi attached. That's how awesome it felt to play as him. He just does everything League Yasuo does, but like 10 times more. Okay, so Yasuo moves. I won't go into too much about the universal mechanics. Riot already posted a video about that, but like the bare basics is that for attacks, there's a light, a medium attack, and a heavy attack. And then there's two special buttons, which I'll refer to as special 1 and 2, and also a tag or assist button. But let's talk about the specials. Special 1 is something every League player should be familiar with, which is Yasuo's Q ability, Steel Tempest. In League, you stack it twice to get a knockup attack, but in Project L, I think it's more so used as a way to pressure the enemy at a relatively safe distance. I don't believe it stacks, but there is a way to enhance the ability, which I'll get into later. Don't worry, he still has his tornadoes. Special 2 is a new ability called Cyclone Slash. When pressed, Yasuo will slice open like a small wind tear of some sort, making this little orb that spins around and hits whoever touches it. He can always hold the button, which will increase the amount of time he's charging, but it'll make the little wind ball go farther. Oh yeah, and he can also do it there. But all in all, I thought it was a neat tool for zoning, though he has some other zoning options as well. And of course, it wouldn't be Yasuo without his infamous wind ball. It's back and functions very similarly to League, as it serves to block incoming projectiles. But what makes it different from League is that the characters without projectiles should still be very, very afraid. Whenever he has it out, he can attack the wall to augment his specials. So remember Yasuo's Q? Now imagine if it was pretty much full screen. And if you attack the wall with a special 2, it turns into a whirlwind that lingers for a bit. So if the enemy blocks it, your team can start pressuring and setting up for a nasty mix-up. And if the enemy gets hit, then Yasuo can follow up and juggle them in the air like he does in League. It almost feels like they sort of moved the Q stacking mechanic to work with his wind wall, and then, of course, he just has like a full screen Q now. Oh, also it doesn't function like it does in League, but you know when you dash in Q and he does that spin attack? Now, you can at least see it in his aerial down heavy attack. Looks really cool, and it was a very core part of the bread and butter combos that was being shown last weekend, so. Now to talk about the third ability that might be familiar. In League, it's his E, and in Project L, it's his forward special 1, Sweeping Blade. When we talk about his dash in general, he just has a ton in his arsenal. Like even outside of his forward special, he has a normal dash, he has a wave dash, one of his assists, air specials that propel him forward, he has a stance dash. Actually, let's talk about the stance. In Project L, probably Yasuo's most notable ability that we've seen in a lot of his gameplay so far is his down special one, called the Quickdraw Stance. A stance in fighting games is a change of form that switches a character's ability or style. So typically they gain access to a new set of moves, but they might lose access to others or have various restrictions. Like for example, in Guilty Gear, Leo's back turn stance gives him increased mobility and tools to mix people up, but he loses the ability to block. A League equivalent would probably be like the transformation champions, such as Jace, since it allows him to switch between a ranged and a melee stance. So in Yasuo's case though, his quick draw stance causes him to sheath his sword and he just sort of stands there menacingly, but from there he can do like a lot of things. Like, so many things I didn't even get to try all of them. But this is where all the creative skill expression will shine. Especially since he's a very flexible character that can cancel a lot of things into the stance and out of the stance. And it's a very large part of why he can do things like this.
People are more experienced. Oh my dude, he's getting the assist, got destroyed! Okay, so that's stance light.
He can also go even more technical and then like Kara cancel after his stances to get an increased range of his attack. But yeah, he does a lot. Lastly, let's talk about the ultimates. So Project L Yasuo has three ultimate abilities. We have two that cost 1 meter each, Blade Storm and Rising Thunder. Here's what they look like.
My blade, my storm.
And then his strongest ability, which costs 2 meter, is none other than Last Breath.
Chase the wind. The field is spice.
I was a huge fan of all of these. They all seem to work really well as combo finishers, and I even got to use one of his level 1s to punish people out of position. And the fact that he just straight up slices the moon in half in his level 2, super cool. It reminded me of Dragonmancer Yasuo's finisher in TFT. I don't know if that was like a coincidence, but still, awesome stuff. And this, at least in this build, is Yasuo specific. He's the only character who could do this of the four champs, but he could actually combo his level 1 into his level 2. And I can't help but think that's just a callback to his kit in League where he combos his Tornado Q into his ultimate. Also, random historical tidbit. A long time ago, Riot Games bought out Radiant Entertainment, which was developing a robot fighting game called Rising Thunder. Eventually, that paved the way to Project L, so there's a little reference to that. But yeah, that's all I have for now about Yasuo the Unforgiven. I want to thank Riot Games for letting me record some footage and for teaching me some of the basics of the game. I know my channel's a weird hybrid of games, VTubing, and art, but if you like, let me know. I'll take any excuse to make more content about Project L. In any case, see ya.